Hello, it's Tertiary Map here. So, the next episode of Mud on a Monday has been postponed. I wanted to do something where, since it's the last month of my first year as a game developer, I've been kind of, you know, really thinking of how far I got, the obstacles that I've dealt with, ones I'm still dealing with, tips I've learned, things that have worked, things that just did not work. And I thought that, you know, this could be something that I can go ahead and just share. It's only my first year, and I came in with no skills. And so when I got started, I often wondered, well, how far can I even get in a year? I don't have a lot of time. I don't have money to, you know, pay for artwork or go ahead and, you know, pay for a programmer. I don't have money like that, you know. I barely have a machine, you know, to be able to run Unity, you know. A year later, and you know, the situation is just very different. All of those answers to those questions are completely different today. And so a lot of that has to do with, you know, sticking to the lessons that I've learned from other developers through YouTube tutorials, through talking to some of them on Twitter, either by commenting on their projects or through DMs, by talking to streamers, talking to pixel artists, talking to programmers, game designers, story writers, talking to anybody that comes into contact with video games, you know, marketing people, just everything. And I feel like I've learned an insane amount in just 1 year. And I can only imagine if I had this at my disposal when I started, but it never works out that way. So instead of waiting for the perfect moment, you know, just get started. And so that's what part one is about: how to just get started, and some of the common things that hold you back as a game developer. And specifically, we'll be talking about which game engine you should choose. The answer is much simpler than you think. Tips on making and completing your first game. That was all my objective. Idea to release, right? So the next section that I'll speak about will be, but I don't have time, don't have money, don't have relevant skills or the right gear. None of that is gonna matter as much as you think, to the point where it's gonna enable you to just, you know, I'm sorry, it's not gonna enable you to just do this. You'll be fine. And then lastly, three truths that you need to identify, because when the going gets rough, you'll always be able to turn back to these three truths: who, what, why. So this will officially be episode 4. This episode that I'm recording will be officially episode 4 of the Mud on a Monday podcast, but it will not be on a specific person. All the episodes up until this point, all three of them, have been on a specific person and specific lessons that I drew from there. And, you know, I thought, you know, would be fun to share. But on this episode, I'll be talking about tips from a rookie game developer who didn't know a damn thing going into this. No coding, no drawing capability, definitely no marketing capability, nothing. Nothing but a pen, some ideas, and a decently working computer that has been so damn good to me over the years. So for anyone else that could use those tips, I thought it'd be pretty neat to talk about. And then revisit a month later with a second part to this, where now it's officially the end of my first year, and I can go ahead and discuss with you what my objectives were, how far I got, and what I plan for the second year, including things that have really, really helped expedite the learning curve. So I should have that up within the next few days. The fifth episode of Mud on a Monday will be released this upcoming Monday. So that is on somebody. I haven't announced it yet. I'll be announcing that tomorrow or Friday. Via, you know, the usual, I will post like a little pixel art of who it's going to be on. And so that'll be up by tomorrow or Friday. And then the new episode will be up Monday. However, this specific episode 4, discussing your first year in game development, is going to be released on the same day. So it'll be 2 episodes, one on, you know, another profile, and one just kind of, you know, sharing some tips that could hopefully be helpful for you. Have a good one. This has been Tertiary Map, and I will go ahead and see you guys soon. Thank you for tuning in. I just figured out how to see the comments on the YouTube channel that was left there, and so I'll be responding to those. There's a few there. So thank you to any and all subscribers. You guys are awesome. Very, very cool. I'm hoping that this next video on you know, rookie game development will be fun, will be informative, and will help give you some extra boost and motivation, and let you know that you're not alone, and a lot of the issues that you're dealing with are issues that you just continue wrestling with, and you learn to tame them, get a grip on them, and you have better days. You know, more often than not, it'll be a better day, and you'll just keep growing from there. But in the beginning, it's really hard. It's really muddy. You know, it's really difficult. It feels really slow. It feels like you're moving at a glacier pace. Just stick with it. Just get those reps in. That's probably one of the biggest things that I learned, is just repetition. You want to do something as many times as you can, especially when you don't know how to think that way, how programmers think, how a game developer has to think. All of those things, unless, you know, you're like a Shigeru Miyamoto, it's not exactly, you know, just natural to you. It's developed. It's acquired, you know? So that is mostly the focal point of the part 1 and part 2. So have a wonderful day, have a good one, and I will see you on Twitter soon.